when not keeping Jesus, there is no one like you. Reliable Jesus, there is no one like you. Covenant keeping Jesus, there is no one like you. Unchangeable Jesus, there is no one like you. God bless you, beloved. God bless you in the name of Jesus. I am your friend, your brother, and your fellow laborer in the vineyard of God. Today, I want to speak on what I titled, When Righteousness Becomes Your Lifestyle. Amen. I will take my text from the book of Psalm chapter 15, from verse 1 to 5. Amen. The Bible says, Lord, who shall abide in thy tabernacle? Who shall dwell in thy holy hill? He that walketh uprightly and walketh righteousness, and speaketh the truth in his heart. Amen. He that backbiteth not with his tongue, nor doeth evil to his neighbor, nor taketh up a reproach against his neighbor, in whose eyes a vile person is contemned, but he honoreth them that fear the Lord. He that sweareth to his own heart and changeth not, he that putteth not out his money to usury, for nor taketh reward against the innocent. He that doeth these things shall never be moved. Amen. Praise the living Jesus. When we talk of righteousness, when we talk about righteousness, it means seeking God without blemish. That is, seeking God without compromise. Amen. When we talk about righteousness, it means making Jesus the Lord of your life. Since you accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, you must seek Him and acknowledge Him in all your ways. Amen. Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior means you cannot do anything without Jesus. You cannot do anything on your own. Amen. Because from the day you accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, you become the servant of God. And as a servant, you don't have the right to do anything on your own. Even if someone slaps you, you don't have the right to retaliate. Amen. Jesus must be seen in your conversation, in your thoughts, in your action, in the way you look. In your marriage, Jesus must be seen. In your secret life, Jesus must be obviously seen. Amen. Jesus must be the controller general of your life. If you must qualify righteous, if you must qualify as a righteous person, Jesus must be your controller general. You must not do anything on your own. Amen. In Psalm 34, verse 10, the Bible says, the young lion do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. That the benefits when you seek God in righteousness. Amen. Hardship, lack become a thing of the past. Amen. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. The reason why people find it difficult to lay hand on what rightfully belongs to them is because seeking God has become a difficult exercise to them. Seeking God in righteousness. Amen. It takes seeking God for you to go out of the neighborhood of want. It takes seeking God for poverty to let you go. It takes seeking God in righteousness for actually to surrender for success in your life. In Proverbs 14, verse 34, the Bible says, righteousness exalts a nation. So righteousness will lift you high. Amen. But sin will bring you down. Amen. Sin condemns any people. Sin is a reproach to any people. Amen. Meaning that righteousness is a key that can take you from lower level to a higher level. Righteousness is a key that can move you from the television to the head. It is a destiny promoter. Amen. When righteousness become your lifestyle, beloved, when righteousness become your lifestyle, you will no longer be a dweller at the ridge, at the territory anymore. Amen. You will suddenly become a permanent dweller at the head region. Amen. When righteousness become your lifestyle, the world you shall be above and not below will suddenly begin to take effect in your life. Righteousness is the opposite of sin. It is good that we know. Amen. Praise Jesus. So to be righteous is to give sinful activities a circulator notice in your life. The benefit of living a sinful life is reproach, condemnation, unfulfilled destiny, frustration and limitation. Amen. Righteousness is one of the greatest keys to divine acceleration. Anyone that wants to see himself growing very fast in all that he or she does, what you need to lay your hand on is righteousness. Amen. Righteousness is the aircraft that can take you to the mountaintop of your destiny. Righteousness qualifies you to sit among those that matters. Amen. While sin, on the other hand, qualifies you for satanic punishment. It qualifies you for eternal condemnation. Sin qualifies you for delay. Sin qualifies you for close heaven. Amen. That is why you see people pray, look as if heaven is very far. Amen. Because there is sin. Amen. Sin qualifies you for negativity. Sin closes the door of blessing against you. Sin is the food that nourishes sickness and infirmity. Sin makes you to be useful for nothing. Sin is a terminator of already manifested miracles. Sin is a terminator of peace of mind. Amen. Sin causes shame and disgrace. Amen. Sin causes physical and spiritual nakedness. Adam suddenly became naked. Amen. When he decided to hearken to the voice of disobedience, suddenly he became naked. He was not hiding. Amen. The Bible calls sin a reproach to any people who practice it. Beloved, the time we are now is the time for us to be serious with our life. Amen. It is the time that we need to understand why we are on earth. It is the time we need to think about where we are going to after this earth. Amen. Time has come for we to stop attending church for fun. The time has come for we to stop attending prayer meeting for fun. This is the time that we are supposed to pray and expect something big from heaven. This is the time to be in a condition or position where heaven can listen to our prayers and then release the answer to our prayers. It is the time to practice Christianity with righteousness and without compromise. Amen. It is the time to practice Christianity in righteousness and without compromise. Praise Jesus. In Psalm 34, verse 15, the Bible says, the eyes of the Lord are unto the righteous. Amen. And his ears are open to their prayers. This is why it is dangerous not to practice righteousness. Amen. Praying without righteousness is a wasted effort, because the Bible just told us that only those that practice righteousness that God can listen to their prayers. Amen. Before any blessing is allowed to depart him, it must pass through the gate of righteousness for proper screening before it can be sent to the beneficiary. Amen. Every good thing you are believing God for blood is in the bosom of righteousness. Your deliverance is in the bosom of righteousness. Your healing is in the bosom of righteousness. Your freedom from satanic captivity is in the bosom of righteousness. Is it children? They are in the bosom of righteousness. Amen. You believing God for your life partner, beloved, begin to practice righteousness through Jesus. In Psalm 34, verse 17, the Bible says, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and delivered them out of their troubles. Amen. The reason why you see people cry every day, go for deliverance, fasting and prayer, their condition remains the same, because righteousness is nowhere to be found. Amen. The righteous cried, and the Lord heareth and set them free from their troubles. Amen. God has committed everything that will make life beautiful for us in the hand of righteousness. Amen. God dropped all the goodness of man in the storehouse of righteousness. That is why only those who seek Him and His righteousness shall have access to their own blessing. Because it is written, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things, all these blessings, shall be added unto you. Amen. Righteousness beautifies a man. Righteousness is the chief character of God Almighty. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, what happens when righteousness becomes your lifestyle? When righteousness becomes your lifestyle, beloved, prosperity becomes your identity. When righteousness becomes your lifestyle, hardship will suddenly become success. When righteousness becomes your lifestyle, testimony will suddenly begin to resurrect from the graveyard of the enemy. Amen. In Isaiah 54, verse 14, the Bible says, in righteousness shalt thou be established. Meaning that without righteousness, there is no establishment. Amen. If a sinner who is baptized with chronic poverty hear this Bible passage and seek can't change from his or her sinful way to enable him to become a candidate of divine establishment, beloved, such individual need to visit a psychiatric hospital for medical checkup. Amen. Only in righteousness shall thou prosper. Amen. In righteousness shall be established. Meaning, only in righteousness shall you prosper. Only in righteousness shall good things follow you. Only in righteousness shall your heaven open. Only in righteousness shall your testimony and miracles manifest. Only in righteousness shall you encounter breakthroughs. Amen. In righteousness shalt thou be established, and thou shalt be far from oppression. Amen. The privilege. Amen. Because you decide to be righteous, oppression will flee from you. Amen. Righteousness places a demarcation between you and oppressors. When righteousness become your lifestyle, beloved, oppression will become once upon a time. Evil hand upon you will suddenly wither. Amen. When righteousness become your last time. The Bible says, thou shall not fear, for terror it shall not come near thee. Why? Because you choose to seek God in righteousness. Amen. The reason why some of us are being oppressed, the reason why things are not working for some of us is because righteousness has gone on indefinite holiday. Amen. Beloved, there are benefits when you seek God in righteousness. There are benefits when righteousness becomes your lifestyle. Amen. Righteousness makes you a terror to the devil. Amen. Righteousness places demarcation between you and limitation. Righteousness is a vehicle that connects you to the throne of grace. Amen. Righteousness qualifies you for heavenly blessing. Righteousness takes you from nobody to somebody. Righteousness gives you authority over the powers of darkness. Amen. Now, if you take righteousness to get to the top of your destiny, what does it take to be righteous? Amen. What does it take to be righteous? First, in the journey into righteousness, the number one bus stop you must not miss, you must not boycott, is to confess Jesus, amen, as a Lord and personal Savior. Two, confess every no and no sin, and repent from them all, and see it as a must to practice holiness, that is, desire to live a righteous life. The Bible says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Amen. And as you practice all this, beloved, the Lord will not forsake you. The Lord will meet you at the point of your needs, in the name of Jesus. And if peradventure you have not yet accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, repeat this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for keeping me alive. I thank you for this particular hour. I thank you for the blood you shed for my sake. Father, have mercy on me. Forgive me all my sins. Today, I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that you are the only begotten Son of God and you died for my sin, for my personal Lord and Savior. From today, Lord, wash me with your blood. Write my name in the book of life. And give me the grace to say no to the devil. Give me the grace to follow you, to seek you in righteousness. In Jesus' name. I pray for you. Father, I thank you for your children that have just accepted you. Everlasting Father, according to your word that says, as many who receive you as they have just done now, give them power to become your sons and daughters. Give them power to triumph over those power that have been tormenting them. Lord, let the power be released unto them now, in the name of Jesus Christ. As a minister of God, the Lord will preserve you, the hand of God be upon you. Do not go back to your vomit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Those good things you have been pursuing before, you will not be the one to be pursuing now according to the will of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, ancient of this. In Jesus' name, I remain your friend, your brother, and your fellow laborer in the vineyard of God. Do not forget to like, to subscribe, and share this message. God bless you as you do. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name.